Tim Cornelius from Atlantis Resources is with me in the studio this morning. Tim, good to see you. Welcome along.
Good morning.
Big week for MeyGen. Phase 1A up and running. So fourth turbine on stream now.
Full turbine installed obviously means that we've now completed the construction phase of phase 1A, 6 megawatts. So now fully connected to grid, generating electricity and most importantly generating revenue and rocks.
An incredibly big project this.
Very big. I mean, in entirety, it'll be about 398 megawatts. So that's over 260 turbines being installed up in the north of Scotland.
Impressively, this latest round of work as well, you've managed to carry out with the threat of Cyclone Ophelia bearing down on you.
Quite right. It's testament actually to now the way that we go and install these turbines is so refined and so efficient that even with Ophelia bearing down on the vessels as we were out there, our team, which we regard obviously as best in the world, were able to install the turbines safely and efficiently and still return home.
News this week, you're pushing the government for a separate subsidy deal. Probably worth just spending a bit of time on this. What are you asking for?
So the MeyGen project requires a certain amount of subsidy now to go and build out the next phase. The next phase of MeyGen is another 80 megawatts, so that's about 51 turbines that would be installed. In order to do that, we need obviously continued support from government, no different to onshore wind, offshore wind or solar. What we specifically asked for is 80 megawatts of capacity. We'd like that at a strike price at around £150 a megawatt hour. And we'd like that to come from the unallocated budget of the recent CFD auction. So we're looking for about 29% of the unallocated funding that was made available on the recent auction round.
Do you reckon you're in for a good show here?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, this is a project which ticks all 10 pillars of the current Conservative government's industrial strategy. This is a project that's not only world-leading, but it creates high-end jobs. It transitions people from the oil and gas industry into the new world, which is renewable energy. And more importantly, it maintains Britain's leading role as the world's developer of marine energy.
Because, of course, you've had incredible support from the Scottish government with regards to this project.
Correct. Now, the Scottish government's support has been unwavering. Without that, we wouldn't have been able to make the incredible advances that we already have. So they're fervent supporters, and obviously this will create a lot of jobs and drive £200 to £300 million of CapEx investment into the Scottish economy.
Just remind us why you think it's so important to have that mix there of renewable energy.
Well, the offshore wind, the most recent auction has obviously demonstrated incredible success for the offshore wind industry. And we're going to see more and more offshore wind get built. But it's incredibly important that the UK has a balanced mix of renewables going forward. We're all very aware of the intermittency arguments around wind. The great thing about tidal power, because it is so predictable, is it actually facilitates deeper penetration of renewables because it provides services to the grid through balancing and being predictable. So we see it as a crucial part of policy to have a very balanced approach now to new renewables, and tidal power makes obvious sense.
Worst case scenario, say you're not successful with getting a separate subsidy deal. Where does that leave you? What are the options?
So, I mean, the government announced late last week that there is a new CFD, a Contracts for Difference round, which is going to be opened up for auction in 2019. So in a worst case scenario for MeyGen, we would participate in the 2019 auction. However, we are lucky in that there are other jurisdictions in the world which are now fervently supporting tidal power. France has aggressively come out looking to announce commercial rounds. Canada has always been a very strong supporter of tidal power. And we're now seeing real traction in Southeast Asian markets. So the reality is that whilst we would wait for a new auction to take place, we would probably focus attention in some parts of Europe and in Southeast Asia.
Plenty happening as well. Of course, recently you've announced your project in Indonesia. They've gone ahead, pushed the button and ordered 8 of your turbines.
Yeah, fabulous. So it's a project which sits on the island of Lombok, very close to Bali. The developer, SBS International, a local developer based in Jakarta, have rights to a project actually in total, which will be 150 megawatts. It's broken into phases. They've reached financial investment decision on phase one, which is eight systems, eight AR 1500 Atlantis turbine systems. So that's our largest equipment order now that's emanated out of Asia.
And that's supported by a 30-year power purchase agreement.
That's right. So the incumbent or the local state electricity company is providing a PPA into that project. It's 30 years and it's sufficient in order to allow the developer to achieve financial investment decisions. So a really big one for us.
A big one for you. Of course, part of your diversification strategy, which is key, your project at the Wyre Valley.
Yeah, so we believe once again that this is an incredibly exciting, but more importantly, a very important project for a sort of a post-Brexit Britain. This is a tidal barrage project. It's 160 megawatts. It's roughly around about a 400 meter long wall or bund that would be built down between Fleetwood and Knott's End. And that's sort of in the Morecambe Bay area down towards Blackpool. It'll provide flood protection services primarily, but it also has 160 megawatts of very predictable generation, which will be done via tidal power. And it also, once again, will provide some ancillary services to the grid. So that's our first foray into sort of larger infrastructure projects, which is a very exciting step for our team.
Lots happening this year. You're excited about 2018 and what it's got in store for you?
Yeah, no, look, you know, we've got incredible prospects now. The fact that we're obviously been developing in Asia, the fact that we've obviously got the ability now to build on the success of MeyGen, which has really taken other governments further along their decision-making path to promote tidal power. The fact that we've got our first infrastructure project in the Wyre Valley, these are all indicators now leading that 2018 and 19 are going to be very, very busy years.
Of course, we didn't speak about it a few moments ago at the time. Huge interest in your retail bond issue. Investors kicking your door down to take part. You raised $5 million in record time.
It was extraordinary. we were obviously delighted with the level of support that we received. It did break all records from what we understand. We worked with Abundance, a very, very professional team who ran the offering. And as you say, we reached our cap probably in two-thirds less of the time that it was predicted that we would. In fact, there was a lot of leftover demand, which obviously we'll look for future bond offerings to be able to offer. But there were over 1,200 investors that participated in that offering, so it really was a fabulous result.
Tim, great to see you. Thanks for coming in.
My pleasure. Thank you.